Today with our topic Forms of Business Organization, we'll discuss about one person company. Now we have already discussed what is one person company. So one person company came into existence 2013 because company act because of the disadvantage of sole proprietorship. Now we'll discuss about disadvantage of one person company. Now first remember, one person company can have minimum or maximum number of members, that is one. A minor shall not be eligible to become member of one person company or can hold shares with the beneficial interest. Only a natural person who is an Indian citizen and resident in India shall be eligible to incorporate person company and shall be nominee for the sole member of one person company. So minor can't become a nominee also. So we have to see that the person who is nominee should be Indian and should be Indian citizen. So we have to look after this. So one person company can have minimum or maximum one member. A minor shall not be eligible to become a member. One person company or can hold shares with beneficial interest, and nominee should be Indian citizen. Second, suitable only for small business. So one person company, because they can arrange only a fixed amount of capital, minimum also a little amount of capital. So it's only suitable for small business. One person company is suitable only for small business. One person company have maximum paid up share capital of rupees 50 lakh or turnover rupees 2 crore. Otherwise, one person company needs to convert into private company. So if capital is more than 50 lakh or turnover is more than 2 crore, then it will convert it into private company. So we have to look for this also. So it should not be more than 50 lakh your capital. Then business activity. One person company cannot carry on non-banking financial investment activities, including investment securities or any corporate. One person company cannot be incorporated or converted into company under Section 8 of the Companies Act. So we have to look for this, that we cannot be incorporated or converted into company under Section 8 of the Act. So then perpetual succession, the concept of separate legal entity being created by perpetual succession, that is continuation of a company even after the death of a member or retirement of a member, the nominee whose name has been mentioned in the memorandum of assent will become the member of the company in the event of death of the existing member. So perpetual succession is there. Separate owner and control. This is one of the features of a company which is seriously challenged by New Companies Act 2013, where the line between the ownership and the control is blurred. So here